Hey guys, my name is Robert. Today, I want to talk about Alter, an AI app that's been part of my daily workflow for a couple of months now. On this channel, I have tested a lot of apps and tools, but I am very selective and only keep a few of them on the long run. When an app does make it into my regular routine, it's because it's the best I have found for a specific job, and that's exactly the case with Alter. Now, when it comes to the AI apps I use every day, the number is quite small. Superwhisper, for instance, is one of them, and I have talked about it several times. It's designed for AI dictation, but I really push it to do much more. Lately, though, several of its limitations have become more obvious to me with the direction of development. Aside from Superwhisper for dictation and automation, whenever I need a real chat interface, I have been relying on TypingMind for quite a while. TypingMind is a web app where you can bring your own API keys and connect to different models. It has plugins, it syncs with my phone, and it offers some useful integrations. But since it's a web app, it feels like something disconnected from the rest of my system. It feels more like something I have to go to instead of something that blends into my workflow. So when I came across Alter and saw its claim of being an AI assistant that works with all of my apps, I was curious. I tested for a bit, and once I understood its features, well, it only took me a few days to decide to buy the lifetime option. Before I go any deeper, let me just clarify something. This video is not a complete walkthrough of every single feature in Alter. That's just too much to cover. I think this is a tool I can continue to explore in future videos, showing different ways to use it. Today, I just want to give you a high-level look at why this app is worth your time and show you some of its possibilities. I also want to share some thoughts on what works well, what feels a bit awkward, and some negatives that I hope get more attention. Alter lives up here in the notch of your Mac. Always a mouse hover away, very accessible, and this also makes it a bit of a headache for me, and I will explain a little bit more about that later. But if you don't like the notch look, you can also hide it. Let's go to settings. Here in appearance, you can select this to toggle it off. And if you toggle it off, you can open the notch with a keyboard shortcut. I highly suggest that you learn your way with keyboard shortcuts with Alter, because that's what will allow you to do things fast. For example, I can be on a website and select some text, and I press my keyboard shortcut, and my selected text already gets added up there as part of the conversation that I'm about to start. This is how you start to build context. Let me go to another app. Let me go to Bear, select some text. I trigger the notch. Again, my selected text gets added. You can add text. You can add images. You can add many different kinds of files. Let me add a PDF. Again, with a keyboard shortcut. Not only that, but you can also add application windows. So let's open, for example, a Bear note here. And now let me open the notch, and it appears here, my current application. And if I add it like this, not only will it add the content of my note, but it will also add a screenshot. And if I want to add content from another app that is not, you know, right in front of me, I can always press add and look through other applications. Whatever I have up here will already be sent as part of my request, so I can already ask, hey, in a few words, tell me what this is all about. Did you notice that? Yes, Alter also has some dictation capabilities. This is kind of like an all-in-one application that can do many things. In some things, it's stronger than others. It can do dictation okay. I don't think it gives you a lot of control or a lot of flexibility as some of the dedicated apps. That's why I still continue to dictate most of what I want with Superwhisper, even when I'm in Alter. But I just wanted to show you that really quickly. And I can start my chat, and I get my response, and there's some actions on here that we will look at in a moment. My conversation gets automatically named, and I can minimize it to move it out of the way. That's just the basics of how you can start using the app. There are many more options up in the notch before you even start a chat. You can use the hash symbol to search and continue previous conversations. You can also search your transcripts because Alter lets you drag audio files to have them transcribed. It even allows speaker separation. By the way, you can let the AI model selection happen automatically or choose a specific model yourself. If you use the paid version of Alter, there's a huge amount of great models included in your payment. There's also a free version of the app that lets you add models with your own API tokens. This app has many useful little hacks to make things faster and more convenient, like the one I showed you of selecting text and opening the notch with your keyboard shortcut to add your selection as context. Another very handy feature is that if you are on a YouTube video and you open Alter, the script of the video will be automatically added up here, and you can already ask something about it right away. Give me a one paragraph summary of what this video is about. And while this happens, I will minimize it. And let me tell you something else. If you end up adding context by accident, you can clear it up with a keyboard shortcut. Or on the other hand, if you have some context files that you end up adding frequently, you can create a workspace. And I also do that with a keyboard shortcut. And a workspace is kind of like a collection of files that get indexed by Alter, and that even if you remove them from here, you can always find them by typing add is down here. So super, super handy. Let me expand the one paragraph summary from the video that I created. One thing I really appreciate about Alter is that even though it packs a lot of features, it doesn't throw everything at you right from the start. You don't have to dig through endless settings just to get going. It never feels overwhelming. Instead, as you start looking for ways to do more specific tasks, you begin to find these little surprises that make everything easier. One of those features, especially if you care about productivity, is Alter Actions. This starts to move us into power user territory, so I'll try to keep it short. Actions work like presets where you set your own system prompt, add custom instructions, and decide which context types get used when you trigger them. Alter comes with a bunch of actions already, but I like having full control, so I turned most of them off and made some of my own. Let's make a simple example together. Let's call it key points. For the system prompt, I will write, "You are an AI assistant. You help the user to the best of your ability. Only give the result without any extra comments." Then, for the user prompt, I will add, "Please extract the most important key points from the following." And now I will drop in the active window content placeholder. You can trigger actions in a few different ways, but I will set a keyboard shortcut for this one. So I go back into the general tab. Let's give this option G. I will also pick a specific AI model. We do that in the advanced tab. Let's go with ChatGPT 4.1. Now I will jump to an article and run the action with my keyboard shortcut. It takes a moment and we can start to see the execution of our action. Once you receive your result, you can keep the conversation going in the same window, let's say. "That's awesome. Now give me a one-sentence summary." Or you also got some very handy quick actions that are totally customizable down here. With this, you can use your results to draft a new email, start a new conversation, insert to your front app, send to other apps via shortcuts or Apple script. And you can run this either manually with keyboard shortcuts, or you can set your actions so that after running, one of these gets executed automatically. This opens up a lot of options because not only can you automate what happens with the results, but you can also use URLs to send parameters right into Alter, using them as building blocks for your actions. We can see that from the same panel where we create our actions. In simple words, you can hook Alter into other automation apps like Raycast, Alfred, Keyboard Maestro, whatever you like. This setup lets me use Superwhisper with Macrowhisper to send my dictation to any Alter action with absolutely no friction. For example, I set up an action that helps me reply emails. It grabs the content from my front window, and it also receives any input I send to it. Here's an email that I received telling me about the latest updates to Alter. This looks really useful. Thank you. If you have used Superwhisper or other dictation apps with context awareness, you may already be able to do some of this. You can select text or send commands based on what's in your screen, but getting your results in this way in a chat interface is super handy, especially if you want to review or tweak your message before you send it off. I can say, make it more formal and professional. You get your results, and again, this works across all your different apps. Here I am on my mail app. I get a lot of emails asking for sponsorships or reviews, and I can say, not interested in this right now. Super quickly, super handy, you can start replying emails like a boss. Now it's right here in the chat view where I need to start talking about some negatives. I want to be completely honest here. The app living in the notch and the floating chat window drives me a bit crazy. I do my best to keep my mouse away from that area and rely mostly on the keyboard to interact with Alter, because hovering to expand and moving the mouse away to collapse gets old fast. It's limiting, and for me it's also very annoying. The idea seems to be that you will drag and drop files up there, but half of the time when I try that, the files end up in the app below, or I accidentally trigger mission control. Sometimes I just want to type a request, but if I move my mouse by mistake, the whole interface disappears. Plus, a lot of people already have other Notch apps, calendars, media players, you name it. I just think that Alter should not fight for that same space, and I personally see this decision as a big mistake. But it's not only the Notch. The floating chat window itself has its own issues. Sure, it looks handy, but you cannot resize it, and it always stays on top. Most window management tools cannot move it, which drives me nuts, because I like my desktop cleanly organized. And there's more. The chat window often loses focus. Sometimes I cannot type in it until I expand the notch again to get focus back. And while we're talking about the chat window, conversation management is really limited. You cannot edit or regenerate previous sent messages. You cannot fork the chat to try a new direction. If you start a chat with context, you have to remove it manually in your next interaction. Otherwise, your conversation context can quickly grow out of control. When you run an automation, like sending results to a shortcut or pasting to your front app, the chat window stays open, so you have to close it manually yourself. There's a chat history panel, and you can star or delete all chats, but there's no way to perform actions in batch. If you want to delete things, you have to do it one by one. So in a lot of ways, the interface and oftentimes the responsiveness of the app feels half-baked. Now, to be fair, there's something that helps make up for some of these headaches, and this is a feature I haven't told you about. You can use Alter as an OpenAI compatible endpoint. This means that if you are on the paid plan, which gives you access to many models like I showed you earlier, you can plug Alter into other apps like TypingMind. So if I want to use Sonnet or ChatGPT in this other app, I don't need to use my own API tokens. I just use Alter's. Since TypingMind has better history management and lets you do more inside the conversation, I use this setup when I'm outlining YouTube scripts or working on bigger documents, where I might want to go back, edit, or try different directions. This feature also means that I can use Superwhisper with internet access. Let me show you. What is a good place to travel right now? This is, once again, Superwhisper by itself, connected to a model provided by Alter. I do not have to use the Notch interface at all. For certain tasks, it definitely is super convenient. This model with web access always gives me sources, so I can click any of these links to find out more. There's still a lot I could cover. I haven't even touched on all the tools and integrations you get with Alter. Over the past several months, I have seen firsthand how this app has been getting consistently better. The developers have been releasing updates every Friday, fixing bugs and making tweaks. As for the issues that I have with the interface, I know that the team is aware and looking at different ways to improve it all. The app itself is very tricky to sum up. On one hand, it is packed with so much potential and can already do so much. It's a really powerful tool, but on the other side, there are still many areas where it misses the mark. For me, outside of the interface problems, the biggest issue I see here has to do with the value that the users get for what they pay. Let me tell you what I mean. You can use Alter for free if you bring your own API keys. You will get a little reminder to upgrade, but you can remove that for $29 a year. That's fair. The real value, however, sits in the paid options, $240 a year or $720 for a lifetime license. That's a true lifetime deal. No subscriptions, no hidden renewal a year later. The price sounds expensive at first, but when you realize you get access to all the available models without paying for your own API usage, it starts to make sense. The website says unlimited requests, which sounds great, especially if you use models like Sonnet, but if you dig a little deeper, you will see those unlimited requests do come with some limits. Here's what the website says. Our top 5% of users currently make about 30 interactions per day without hitting fair use limits. If you exceed the fair use budget, which resets monthly, we may route your queries to more cost-effective models instead of premium ones. So most requests are unlimited, but there are caps for the most expensive models. That makes sense. Some of these models are pricey to run. But then let's get to the details on fair use. Our fair use policy uses a monthly budget system rather than arbitrary message limits. When your budget is exceeded, we will transparently route your requests to alternative models. For the API gateway, there's a limit of 200 requests per day before throttling to one request per 10 minutes. You can top up your budget if you need consistent access to premium models beyond the fair use limits. In other words, if you are using Alter's API with TypingMind or another app, you get 200 requests a day. And that's clear, perfect. But if you are using the app itself with premium models, they only warn you after you have gone over the limit. I have given feedback about this for the longest time. I think they should show some kind of numbers or at least a graphic to help users keep track of how much they have left in their monthly budget. Let me clarify here. I am not against having these limits. What bothers me is the lack of transparency. For me, a big part of the value is not just in the app's features, but access to the premium models included in the price. It seems like the idea is that the limits are so high so the users shouldn't worry about them, but for me, it just has the opposite effect. Not long ago, I built Macrowhisper, this small automation app for Superwhisper. About half of this project was developed using Alter. It's not the best tool for coding, but it works if you don't mind a lot of copying and pasting. Still, it made me super nervous and was just waiting for the day that I would wake up with a notification telling me that I couldn't use Claude models for the rest of the month unless I paid more. I haven't hit the limits myself, and I haven't heard of any other paid users running into them, but it just feels like flying blind, and that should not be the case for an app that costs $240 a year or $720 for life. So, would I recommend Alter? If the team adds more clarity around usage, then I would say 100% yes. But for now, I will leave it up to you. With this video, I just wanted to help you make an informed decision. Honestly, I still find it quite amazing. It's definitely not perfect, but it's already doing a lot that other apps just cannot match, especially with its AI features, system integration, and automation options. If you care about productivity, I think Alter is worth checking out. There are some rough edges, and I hope those get smoothed out. But what's also exciting to me is that this app is still growing and the team listens a lot to user feedback. So jump in, join the Discord, and share your thoughts. They are shaping the app with our input. The progress I have seen so far has been impressive and the team is clearly invested. I would love to hear your thoughts or answer any questions that you have. There's still a lot more to cover about this app, so let me know if there's something specific you want to know about it. If you want more updates on what I'm up to, feel free to join my newsletter. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.